Alright, so today I decided to play Inside. It's a game that came recommended to me. It's by the same people who made Limbo. It's a puzzle platformer, side-scrolling kind of game. I had the idea in my head of doing a blindless play of something for a while, and this seemed like a good one to do. I have to admit, this isn't totally blind playthrough, because I played a bit of it before this. I'll let you know when I'm caught up with the part that I played already. But yeah, just kind of the game. There isn't even a menu screen. The game kind of just throws you right into it here, not having any idea what's going on. Kid wandering through a forest with some kind of operation going on in the background there. And yeah, these guys spot you. it's bad if they see you. So have to watch out for them. There's no dialogue as far as I'm aware. You just kind of have to sort of get clues from what's going on around you. Get an idea of what's going on. I'm not pushing anything to make him crouch or walk slowly or whatever. He just does that automatically. He kind of automatically alters his gait depending on what's going on around him. I can pull over here. I'm going to push it instead of pulling it, because I think it might drop on my head if I try pulling it. Oh, and somebody spotted me. And he's missing a dog. I'm sure it's a very nice dog, but I want to get away. Wow. I think it's really neat about this, like, especially compared to Limbo, where everything's it's very similar style, but it's all black and white with creepy silhouettes. This goes for more realistic appearance, and got some pretty nice, pretty beautiful rendered backgrounds here. Like, it make it feel like. Somebody spotted me there again. Okay. Hide behind the rock. Maybe they didn't spot me. Yeah, like, it's on a. The whole thing is on a 2D plane. But the stuff in the background feels like it's part of what's going on. And I guess I can show you what happens. Yeah, if they see you, they just shoot you. Well, the game's very forgiving about that. It just rewinds it to just before that happened. Unlimited lives, you can just try as many times as you want. this time I'm not going to run right there while the vehicle is coming around. Whoops. Okay, whoops, maybe I shouldn't have done that. I should have just kept running. I lingered too long. Okay, for real this time. Okay, jump over the log, because if I don't, I trip. And then he catches me anyway. Wait for the vehicle to go by. Okay, run. Not quite sure why they don't shoot me now, but... all kinds of questions like why are they chasing after this kid? Oh, and for the second time I escaped the dog by jumping off a cliff. Fortunately I landed in water, which is a universal sign of oh, he's gonna survive the fall. I did this before, I didn't try going this way, but I cursed me this time. I mean, I witnessed someone else playing and they went this way and there's a thing here, so I, let's see, I don't think there's anything this way. Is that something I can interact with there? Ah, there we go. Yeah, the first time going through this part, I just kind of plunged on forward and kept going. I should have explored a bit. Can't stay underwater too long, but I think I should go underwater for the part where they're. The light is, at least. In fact, I want to stay underwater as long as I can here. I don't know how well they're able to see me there. And now I'm soaking wet, and it's raining. Sucks to be this guy. I think I hate more than wet socks. Or wet everything in this case. But yeah, I think it's... it's kind of cool. Like, it's 2D in the sense that I'm just on that one plane, but there's all this stuff in the foreground and the background, and they interact with each other, and it's a pretty cool effect. It's how it all blends together. And there's little chicks following me. I think they're chicks, like little baby chickens. So they look like, they don't sound like they're making chick sounds, but... There's a pile of dead animals, they look like pigs there. Not sure why they're all drawn to me, I guess I'm just a chick magnet. I can grab that rope there. Yep. Like I said, I've done this part already. Can I just climb down? Okay, I'll just jump down, whatever. It's pretty hardy, you can take that fall. And you can open the door and you can let the chicks in, which is conspicuous in this game. You know, when stuff like that happens, immediately know there's about to be a puzzle that uses those chicks somehow. Lover doesn't seem to do anything. Let's start the generator. Once the generator is going, if you listen, the switch lights up and it starts spewing stuff at that little, I guess it's a bale of hay up there. There's a wall I can't get over, I need something to climb up on. But there's nothing to climb up on. Chicks are still following me around. If I hit the switch here, it sucks the chicks in. Those poor chicks. Ah, they're okay though. It's like a long fall, but there's nowhere else to go, so we just kind of have to take a leap of faith here. And, I guess the dead pigs broke his fall. He's okay. Through mud now, yeah. From what I've heard, those pigs aren't actually that big for real pigs. Real pigs are like cow sized. They're bigger than if you think, than they get, like if you live in the city like me. And that, oh, that pig is not quite dead. Ow. Parasite, some kind of wormy thing coming out of it. Coming out of, I don't know. Either it's coming out of a wound in his side or it's coming out of his butt. But either way, it's kind of gross. But I guess he just needed to be dewormed because now he's all calm. You can just grab him and pull him over here. And grab this mysterious thing here. Grab it. It's attached to my head, and suddenly, when I move, I can move these guys in the background. And it seems I can control them. Any button I push, like they all do in unison. It's kind of trippy, but it's the first clue is about. Push it up, pull that. There you go. When I disconnect, they just all slump down. It's the first clue about what is going on here. Yeah, you can put it down. Yeah, like I said, I would have preferred to do this whole thing totally blind, but it didn't occur to me to do that until I'd gotten a good ways in, like into the facility. There's a lineup of more people kind of slumped over, like those mind control guys were. Wall here, so I can't go any further that way. I can push and pull this thing. If I push it, that chain goes up. If I pull it this way, the chain goes down. I can move it as far as I can go in order to reach the chain. Yeah, the puzzles so far have been pretty simplistic, but kind of trusting they're going to get more complicated as it goes on. So far, the most complicated thing so far is the chick one. There's anything that way. It's not no leap of faith gameplay at this point. This thing can be pushed and pulled, and it's blocked by that those two little blocks in the background there. And I think this thing can, yeah, you can raise it up or down. Maybe one a little further down than that, because I guess I can jump to it from up here. There you go. And there's the safe here, and you can see there's a rope connecting it to this plank. This plank looks very non-sturdy, so. Mistaken, there's another secret thing over here, like that weird thing in the secret area. Oh, it's it isn't lit up this time. We did this first time around, that was lit up just like the one at the beginning, and pulling on that got me an achievement, I guess. I'll need to do that the one time. Anyway. Continuing on. So, okay. So that opens the door. Is it one of those mind control thingies? And there are two of these guys walking in opposite directions. And you can see there are two touch plates there. Every time one of them steps on the touch plate, the thing lights up on the right there. So you have to get them both stepping on the touch plate at the same time. So close that door again. And they're braced up against the walls so we can get both standing on it at the same time. There you go. And the door opens, and we continue on. hear that, but the sound of many footsteps walking in unison, like on a march. It's a very run-down looking place. The lettering isn't there. It's clearly like a big operation they got going on, but it's a rather run-down looking place. Kind of post-apocalyptic or something. Whoa! I was not expecting to be able to catch that. I hit the button by mistake. Somehow I survived. Oh. Okay. Control people. It's seemingly endless line of them. You can hear the marching sound much louder now. And it's all very eerie. It's just, again, it's just, don't really know what's going on. This mysterious rundown facility has some kind of mind control facility or something. Some kind of experimental military tech, who knows? What you can do from here, but you know from before that I can move the ladder. I swear, we're pretty soon we're coming up to the part where I haven't played up to yet, and then I'll be able to take on these puzzles, you know, like blindly for the first time. So here there's an elevator, but can't do anything with it because it has no power. And back over here, there was a switch I walked right past. It turns on the power, but it also turns on these machines that can scan for me. Ah, crap. Wasn't quite hidden there. Yeah, the first time I did this, I just turned the machine on right away. Ran out there, made to the elevator, but the elevator door was still closed, and I'm scrambling to open it while they're zapping me. Speaking of breaking, and I think I just might have just killed somebody there. Fell on top of the mind control person, and now I have to pretend to be mind controlled. Nothing suspicious here. If I don't walk when they walk, I get zapped again. There's more kind of world building going on here. Some kind of test as a crowd of people. It looks like there are children among them. Just what kind of operation are they running here? I see when they're behind that yellow line there, they turn left and then turn right again, so I'm gonna have to do that when I get there. So this is some kind of either test or demonstration or something? Camera has a spotlight on me all this time. Ready to zap me at any moment, but I left the camera behind now. But there's still people watching me in the background. I bet the dog's suspicious. Oh, and they spotted me, and I'm running for it. Excuse me. And for the third time I escape a dog by jumping off a cliff. Probably still coming at me. And for the fourth time too. Is that limited range? Huh. I can't walk any further than that. I'm just curious. So yeah, there's a door that blocks in there, but if I move this on top of it, then you can go further. Go from the machine here, or I'm going to draw to my death. This guy can still go around here. Touch plate opens the door, but as I step down, I close it again, so I have to find another way. Fortunately, there's a second mind control machine up here, and here we like create a chain reaction. And there's a second guy. And the second guy we have standing on the touch plate. And then disengage from my controller, and then the first guy can move me through. And there's something vaguely disturbing about the fact that I'm borrowing other people's bodies here. There's a lever here that opens the door down there, and the people on the floor are looking alarmed. What the heck? Why is that door open? As soon as I release it, it closes again. So I'm going to move this thing back as far as I can to the left side of that big door without it still being over the door. goes as far as it goes. And another leap of faith, just drop down. Trusting to survive. Yeah, I landed in water. Again, universal sign of, I'm fine. I just landed in water. I don't suppose there's anything down here, is there? Oh, here's a thing. Am I catching a red thing? Can I pull this? There you go. Back to the surface. Don't drown. Something that size, even though, you know, some buoyancy would help help take less effort to push, it'd still take a fair bit of effort to push something that size. What do I know? Not that I'm an expert in these things. Okay, at this point, but my watch about a half hour into this video, and this is where I played up to the first time around. So starting at this point, I'm playing blind. I have no idea what's coming up. So here we go. What does this do? Push a button and looks like the water level went down. Looks like it was full of water. I'm gonna hazard a guess that button is going to fill it back up again. And that's probably what I have to do, because it doesn't seem to be any other way forward. So here we go. Oh crap. Oh, the door closed. Okay, so chain there. Can I go this way? My first thought was I have to push the button and then go back to that door wall before the, can I do anything with this? I'm standing on it. Yeah, don't try opening it while you're standing on it. That's just silly. Okay, does this need to be in here? Does this just, ow. It just goes back here again. Drain the water out again. Okay, so there was nothing up there, just assuming I swim down, hit the button again, and then swim up fast, get up there. Get up on that ledge quickly. There we go. It's dark in here. It's very dark in here. Move this thing. I can move it around. I can still push it down here. Is there something I can do with this? It's the only thing I can interact with here, so I'm assuming. Oh, wait. I'll bet this floats. I'll bet this floats in the water. Okay, so I can grab the chain. I get it. System here. So not quite abandoned. Oh, there's a big spotlight there. I was casting those shadows earlier. Speaking of shadows, there's a big shadow of a pipe here. I have a feeling I have to stand in that. What does this do? Let me pick it, hang over the edge to, so it doesn't spot me. No such luck. Let's try this again. Okay, standing in the shadow of the pipe. Let's pull this thing. Can I just... Okay, I can just hold down the down button. Back in the shadow again. Wait for it to pass. Wait for it to pass again. Is that low enough? Can I jump across to that now? I think. I'm gonna go for it. Pardon me, and uncontrolled fellows. Whoa. I'm okay. Another pipe shadow right over here. Those trains are obviously quite active. There's another red door thing there, so I feel like I can open this. Huh. Back inside again. There's a piano in the background. Walk across. Oh, oops. Oh, I survived, so I guess. Kind of rule of thumb in this game is if you survive, then you're probably supposed to go that way. Kind of wanted to try jumping, but it wasn't clear where the edge was. That's gotta be pretty nerve wracking. I mean, I'm pretty tall, but I'm kind of afraid of heights. It's, climbing on a chain like that, just, I don't know, I'd find that scary. So we go, I went from that train station, which looked like it was fully in service, to this dilapidated, broken down thing. Again, I'm not pushing anything to crouch, it's just doing that automatically. Is that you're expecting something to come? Oh, no, more dogs. Am I gonna have to jump off another cliff? Another swimming section. I saw something red down here. What's that? Oh. I don't think I'm gonna interact with that. And I think those little jerking motions he's doing is because he's like, ah, I'm drowning. Get back to the surface now. Okay, I don't see anything else to interact with down here. I guess I could just have to continue. But the dog is up here, isn't it? Aw, oh, man! Bad dog. Yep, just got mauled by a dog. I guess I should have been running there. It's time to come out. I'm just gonna run for it. Run, run, run. Okay, I get this. Running was not the solution. Don't suppose I can jump over the dog's head like I did with the pig earlier. Or maybe I'm supposed to jump back into the water. What if I jump back into the water? Follow me? There are more of them. Oh man. Climb, 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 climb. Just jump off. Get the heck out of here. What does this do? Do I have to pull it? Oh, frig. Oh, I'm rolled again. Wasn't clear what I was supposed to do there. Apparently I have to pull those planks off. Do I have time to do that? Side now. Wait for it, wait for it. Alarm us. Pull, pull, pull. The fence is looking a little shaky. I hope it isn't about to fall down or something. They can follow me through that gap there, so I want to make sure I have as much time as possible. Alright, run, run, run. Let's go, let's go. Oh, okay. Maybe they can't follow me. Huh. He's not slumped over, so I have a feeling it's an actual guy and not a mind control guy. Oh, what have we here? Some kind of submarine? I have a feeling I don't want them to see me. But they look like they're busying themselves with whatever they're doing there. So, can I take their submarine? All right. That's kind of cool. What's down here? Using the left and right arrow keys is pointing the flashlight in different directions. Do I want to continue down there? Do I want to kind of explore more? Is there anything over here? I guess not. I guess I want to go down? Or maybe I wanted to explore that other way. Looked like there might have been more stuff to the right. I don't know. The door just opened for me? Okay. I kind of want to, just in the off chance that there, I don't want to take too much time out of the recording for this, but just in the off chance that there are more of those secret machine thingies, whatever they are, over this way, I want to make sure I explore. You know, I want to do all the optional areas first, and that place looked like it was the way forward. Okay. Okay, never mind. There was nothing here. A waste of time. Back to that mysterious red door. Those planks down there look, they look flimsy. Do I have any? I'm pulling down the use button, it's, I guess it just makes it hold in place. Like, I can't hit it with enough momentum to, like, break it. Must be something else I'm supposed to do here. But I don't see what at present. Pulling the use button just makes a little place here. Oh, what was that? Do that. Can I do that again? Only downward? Is holding down the use button like charge something up or something? There we go. I'm going to the left. The whole game I've been going to the right, so I figure, go to the left first for the sake of exploration. See if there's another secret or something here. Or maybe it's just a wall. Okay. Let's go down. How did this go? Much larger, much more open area here. Answer some questions like, why do they have this submersible machine here? So there's some connection to the mind control machines? Or is it just more broken, dilapidated stuff? In the wall. I have a feeling that's why I want to go through that, but first I want to take a look over here. But yeah, and just for exploration's sake, I have a feeling there's nothing else here except that crack. And I'm going to have to do the supercharge move thingy to break through that. There it is. see over here. Fairly extensive underwater facility. I mean, I say facility, but it looks like it's long broken down and abandoned, like it wasn't constructed for this purpose. Surface. Anything up here? Didn't really think so. Let's go back to that crack. Is that a window which is cracked in the background there? The light source beyond it. Maybe we should try smashing through that. Didn't like much how the lights blinked inside the submarine. Hope we're not damaging this thing. Through that. Am I gonna like bring this whole facility down in my head or something? I mean, still breaking stuff. So I guess that's still making progress. Something to get through though. Is there something I'm missing? One more crack right here. Is that like red herring or something? Is that just there to mislead me? Am I supposed to be smashing this wall here? That didn't seem to do anything. Like, am I doing anything to it? Am I making progress by smashing into this again? Something else I'm supposed to do. Like, maybe I'm supposed to use the supercharge thing to charge upwards and fly out of the water. So this seems to be an option, but I can't do anything with that. Or can I? Something I'm missing, there's something down here. I feel like I'm missing something here. Can I smash through that metal fencing at the widest part here? Wait, it doesn't seem to have any effect. Is there another crack at the bottom there? I'm not at all clear what I'm supposed to be doing at this point. Smash as much of that as I can. Can I climb out? Oh, I can climb out. Am I just supposed to swim through that? I guess that's the only way I can go forward. Bye-bye, little sub. You were a good companion for a short time, but I have to leave you behind now. Or so it seems. Sub soaking wet again. And there's a rope to climb, so let's climb it. Climbing rope is hard enough when you're not soaking wet. It's, let's see, I think I didn't want to drop off the edge there. Lighted panel back. Oh, it's another window. I have a feeling there's water on the other side of that glass there. Oh crap, 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 what the heck? What? What's that all about? Going to store these huge rolling cylinders. Let's put them at the top of an incline on the other side of a door. I thought that button was going to I was going to make the place fill with water or something. This is all weirdly slanted and sloped here. Kind of grow up here, what? What is that? Huh. Okay, I'll come back to that. Push the use button and it turned on. I have a feeling I have to ride it somewhere, but first I'm going to take a look around this area. I had a feeling there's going to be a wall here. Okay. Back to the machine. Although it's close to an hour, maybe this is a good time to take a break from this and come back to this another time. In fact, I'm gonna end this video here, and I'll divide this up into multiple parts. So until next time, here we go.